Good afternoon, students. Today we will start our new chapter, that is solution. That is your chapter second in your syllabus of chemistry. Okay, the common chapter in CBSE and RBSE both. So first we talk about the solution. The term solution, we define it as homogeneous mixture of two or more than two components. That is a solution. So solution is a homogeneous mixture. The thing is that homogeneous mixture are those mixture which have same composition throughout the solution. That is homogeneous. Okay. So if more than two or more than two components is a mixture of two or more than two components, so different kind of solutions are there, different types of solution are there. Solution may be binary, ternary, quaternary, pentanary and multinary possible. In this chapter we talk about only binary type of solutions which have only two components. One is solute and another component is known as solvent. In this unit, we are limited to only binary solutions. We talk about only binary type of solutions. Okay, so the most of the solutions are binary in nature. Okay, and what say about the components? Components are solvent and solute. If a component present in large amount or large quantity, then it is called solvent. While component which present in a smaller quantity is called solute. Then some of the students raise a question that suppose both the components are having same quantity, then how we decide which one is a solvent? Then the very good question. So you have to determine the solvent on the basis of boiling point. The component which having lower boiling point will be the solvent. Okay, that's it. Come to the next. So various laws are formulated for the solution, but in this chapter we talk about only two kinds of law related with the solution. These are Henry's law and Raoult's law. What say Henry? It asserts that at a constant temperature, the solubility of a gas. Basically, Henry law is formulated for the solubility, the relation between solubility of a gas with the liquid. While Raoult's law is formulated for the putting a relation between vapor pressure of a gas and concentration, that means solubility. So you can see here Henry's law states that at a constant temperature the solubility of a gas is directly proportional to partial pressure or the pressure of a gas above the surface of liquid. Okay, it also states that partial pressure is represented by P while the solubility is represented by X. So P is directly proportional to X. If we eliminate the proportionality sign, then we have to put a constant, that is KH, that is also known as Henry's constant. Okay, if we find the unit of Henry's constant, it become unit of pressure equal to unit of pressure. Why? Because that mole fraction, that is never have any kind of unit, is a unitless quantity. KH, the unit of KH is just similar to the pressure. That means Henry's law constant is measured in atm or bar. Next, application of Henry's law. So what are the applications in our day-to-day life? First we talk about the soda water bottles or the soft drinks bottles, where carbon dioxide is mixed with the soft drink liquids. Okay. Now, second is to avoid the bent situation, we use scuba diver cylinders. And the composition of scuba diver cylinder is decided by and according to decided according to Henry's constant of a cases. Our bent situation is the very panic situation of the patient, where dinitrogen is dissolved with the blood, and as we come to the sea surface, then this dissolved nitrogen gas comes out in the form of bubbles. So that situation is creating very panic death of a patient or scuba divers. So nowadays scuba diver cylinders are filled according to Henry's constant of a gas. Next is Raoult's law, the second gaseous law. It states that for a solution volatile liquid, for a volatile type of the liquids, or liquid which can form the vapor are called volatile liquids, the partial vapor pressure of each component is directly proportional to mole fraction present in the solution of that component. Suppose we talk about the partial pressure of a component. Let assume that in a solution there are two components, one is solute and another is solvent. Solute is represented by capital B, while solvent is represented by capital A. Okay, so the partial pressure of A is directly proportional to mole fraction of A in a solution. As we eliminate this proportionality sign, then we have to use this constant, that is P naught A, that is a vapor pressure of component A in its pure state, that is denoted by P naught A. As similar, the partial pressure of component B, that is solute B, PB is equal to P naught B XB. That is the mathematical expression for the Raoult's law. Okay, suppose both the components are volatile, then total pressure must be the sum of partial pressure due to A component and component B. Okay, it may be possible that one of the component is non-volatile, while another component, if the solute is non-volatile here, then it doesn't contribute to total pressure. So the total pressure is only equal to P total is equal to PA only. We have to write PA is equal to P naught A and solubility of component A, that is XA. Okay, that's it. And there is a hint that A is a solvent and B denoted to solute. Come to the next, types of solution. So basically, types of solutions can be divided into two categories on the basis of Raoult's law. Suppose solution follow the Raoult's law. Okay, at all concentration and particular temperature, then they are called ideal solutions. If solution never follow Raoult's law, then that means it is a non-ideal type of solution. Okay, ideal solution, in case of ideal solution, the solution which obey Raoult's law over the entire range of concentration. Okay, and the condition is that the enthalpy of mixing and the volume of mixing of pure component must be zero. Okay, so for the ideal solution, enthalpy of mixing and the volume of the mixing, change in volume of the mixing must be zero. Okay, so conditions, what are the conditions? That PA must be equal to PA naught, product of PA must be equal to product of partial pressure of that gaseous component into mole fraction of that component in solution, and PB is equal to P naught B with XB. Okay, the second condition is that delta enthalpy of mixing is zero. That means during mixing of solute with the solvent, there is no evolution and absorption of heat would take place. Okay. As similar, if we mix, delta V mix means the change in volume before mixing two solvents. Let take some example here. For example, 10 ml solvent is combined with the 10 ml of solute. Then the total volume of the solution must be 20. Only at that time, del V must be 0. If the total volume of the solution is either less or more than 20, then that indicates the delta V mixing never be equal to 0. This is the only possible if AB interaction, that means the interaction between solvent and solute, is nearly equal to the dose of A and BB interactions. Example solution, of course, some of the examples are there of this ideal solution, that is N-hexane, N-heptane, chlorobroethane, bromoethane. There are various examples, but I will write only a single example. For the next non-ideal type of solution, those solutions which do not follow are also very easy. Okay, and their pH is not equal to pH not A and XA. Second thing, their enthalpy of mixing either exothermic or endothermic is not equal to their enthalpy of mixing never equal to zero. That means it may be endothermic or exothermic. Another thing is there, third condition, the delta V mixing must not be equal to zero. That means either solution increase in the volume, total volume, or decrease in the total volume. So vapor pressure of such solution is either higher or lower, and because of these conditions, the vapor pressure of such solution may be higher or lower than the predicted problem, but does not follow their outcome. That's why they are called non-ideal solutions. Come to the next types of non-ideal solutions. Basically, non-ideal solutions are of two types. One, those non-ideal solutions which show positive deviation, and those non-ideal solutions which show negative deviation. Okay. What does mean by this positive and negative deviation? So the mean of positive and negative deviation is that those non-ideal solutions which show positive deviation, their vapor pressure is higher from the expected vapor pressure. While those ideal solutions which show negative deviation, their total vapor pressure is lower than their expected P total. Okay. Examples are already given. Vapor pressure is increases from our expected value because AB interactions are weaker. If there is a very less interaction between A and B is there, that means solute and solvent interactions are not good enough. That's why they goes to the vapor phase, and they will result in increase in P total. Okay, as similar, if vapor pressure is lower, the solution show negative deviation. That means their interaction also stronger enough. That's why they never goes to the vapor phase and never increase the P total. For example, chloroform and acetone, they are having dipolar interactions. But in case of ethanol and acetone, ethanol is already have a hydrogen bonding. While acetone is interact with the acetone atom compounds, acetone interact with the acetone with the help of dipolar interactions. But as we mix both of the compounds, then there is a decrease in hydrogen bonding, and because of that it show positive. But after mixing chloroform acetones, interaction are so good enough, there is a stronger bonding in between chloroform and acetone as compared to the particle of chloroform and the particle of acetone and acetone. That's why it show negative deviation. There delta H mixing is also negative and delta V mixing is also negative. Okay. So those solution with non-ideal solution which show positive deviation, they are having positive values for the del H mixing and del V mixing, and those negative deviation showing solutions are also having negative value of delta H of mixing, that means enthalpy of mixing negative, and volume mixing will also be negative. Come to the next variety, that is azeotrope type of the mixture. Basically, they are the type of non-ideal type of solutions. Okay, but they are included in a different category. Why? Because of their specific characteristic, and that is that the mixture of a liquid having same composition in their liquid and vapor phases, because they are having same composition in their liquid and vapor phases, and they can't be separate with the help of distillation. Okay, because they are boiling points of the components are become same, so we can't separate solute and solvent for such solutions. Okay, for example, minimum boiling point assumed. The solution which shows a large positive deviation from the Raoult's law, for example, ethanol in water. Ethanol 95% and water must be 5%. That is the only composition at that time this mixture have minimum boiling point azeotrophs. That mixture called minimum boiling point azeotroph. The concentration will never show azeotrophic nature. Okay, as similar maximum boiling point azeotroph, those solution which show large negative deviation from the Raoult's law. For example, 68% nitric acid and water must be 32%. What is the mean by this percentage? 68 ml of nitric acid and 32 ml of water we mix together. At that time, the solvent mixture is behave as a maximum boiling point azeotrope, not in other concentration. Remember it again. Okay, so azeotropic mixture is a fixed composition, and whatever percentage I say, that must be written in your examination. You must write the percentage along with the particular mixture. Only at that time they are treated to be azeotropic. Come to the next. This is all are about today lecture. This is your worksheet. So you have to complete your worksheet here. Okay. First question is that what is azeotropic mixture? You can easily find the answer. Is that Raoult's law, Henry's law? That's well known question. Henry constant inversely proportional to solubility. As the value of KH increases, solubility will decrease. What is a non-ideal solution? Give examples. You know a lot of examples here. One is nitric acid and acetone, ethanol plus water. They all are the examples of non-ideal type of solutions. Now question number 5. Give the reason. Tank used by the scuba divers are filled with the air diluted with helium because of to avoid dense situation or weaken night because of high KH value, that is Henry's constant value, that is greater for the helium atom, and because of that we can use. Okay, so we made some correction here. You can see here the give the reason text you tanks used by the scuba divers because of the value. Answer is because value for the Henry constant for helium is higher, and to avoid bend situation, that means panic death of scuba diver due to formation of bubbles in his implant. Okay, come to the next. We can also write another question here. Question number 6. Okay. Give reason. What the question? Give the reason. Azeotropic mixture can't be separate by distillation. So give the you have to give the reason why azeotropic mixture can't be separate with the help of distillation, because the composition remains same. Because the answer is because the composition remains same in their liquid as well as in their vapor phase. Okay. So this is all about the your worksheet. So you have to complete worksheet at the same day, and you must note this question in your answer sheet also. Answer, you prepare your own notes by using these slides or the lecture video. Okay, this is all about today lecture. Okay, so you can see here, you can see the questions again. Some of the students were not note these questions. You can write again these questions. Give the reason. I hate this question. Question number 6. Azeotropic mixture can't be separate by distillation. You have to give the answer. So the answer must be because the composition remains same in the air liquid as well as in the air vapor phases. Okay, this is all about today's lecture. Tomorrow I will continue our chapter. Okay. So thank you. Have a nice day.